Sometimes, not even being a celebrity can keep you out of jail. Today on Ranked, we're counting down the top 10 celebs you didn't know who went to jail. Before we jump in, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified about all our new videos. A few years after Matthew McConaughey played a burnout stoner on Dazed and Confused, he was arrested for just the type of thing that his character David Wooderson would do.
How you doing?
In October 1999, police were called on a noise complaint to McConaughey's house where he was dancing around and playing bongos completely naked, aside from a University of Texas bandana. He was arrested on suspicion of possession of marijuana, possession of drug paraphernalia, and resisting transportation.
Say, man, you got a joint?
In the end, he was only charged with resisting transportation. Following an overnight stay at the Travis County Jail, where he wore a prison-issued gray jumpsuit, McConaughey posted $1,000 for bail and was released.
To that, I say, all right, all right, all right.
While Bill Gates is often seen as the dorky, glasses-wearing founder of Microsoft,
hello. I'm Bill Gates.
He's also got a bad boy side that includes going to jail. The tech geek has always felt the need for speed, with an affinity towards Porsches. In 1977, when Gates was 22, he bought himself a Porsche 911 Turbo when Microsoft was based in Albuquerque. He was arrested for speeding, and his Microsoft co-founder, Paul Allen, had to bail him out. After the company moved to Seattle, Gates got three more speeding tickets, two of which came from the same cop. Gates held on to the car until the 90s before it was sold, making its way to Austin. Bruno Mars might be known for the song Locked Out of Heaven, but at one point he was locked in prison. In 2011, the young budding singer was arrested in Vegas on a cocaine possession. Mars was found with a bag of cocaine in the bathroom of the Las Vegas Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. He was booked into county jail on suspicion of possession of a controlled substance. Mars was given 12 months probation and a $2,000 fine, 200 hours of community service, and ordered to attend drug counseling. After a year of staying out of trouble, the cocaine possession charge was dropped. In October 2016, Shailene Woodley was arrested and charged with criminal trespassing and engaging in a riot while protesting the controversial Dakota Access Pipeline at the Standing Rock Reservation in North Dakota. At the time, she live-streamed the arrest on Facebook. In the video, she claimed she was arrested because I'm well-known and because I have 40,000 people watching.
It's because I'm well-known. It's because I have 40,000 people watching.
As other protesters were allowed to leave, Woodley originally pled not guilty to the misdemeanor charges. She later accepted a plea deal in which she pleaded guilty in exchange for 1 year probation. She also paid a $500 fine. In 2017, Shia LaBeouf was arrested by the Savannah, Georgia Police Department on charges of public drunkenness. The Chatham County Sheriff's Office said the 31-year-old was arrested in a hotel lobby at 4 a.m. He also faced charges of disorderly conduct and obstruction. Police claimed that he asked a bystander for a cigarette, and when they refused, he became disorderly, using profanities and vulgar language in front of the women and children present. LaBeouf then ran into a nearby hotel to avoid arrest, which clearly didn't work.
Just do it!
In 2007, Michelle Rodriguez was sentenced to 180 days in a Los Angeles jail for violating probation on previous drunk driving and hit-and-run offenses. She admitted to failing to complete community service obligations, contrary to a signed document stating otherwise. She was also found to have consumed alcohol on multiple occasions while wearing an ankle monitor bracelet, in violation of a probation requirement that she remain sober for 90 days. In 2004, Rodriguez pleaded no contest to three traffic offenses in Los Angeles, including a hit-and-run and drunk driving. She was sentenced to 60 days in jail in 2016 for a probation violation, but was released after 4 hours due to overcrowding. Winona Ryder was arrested on shoplifting charges in December 2001 after being accused of stealing $5,500 worth of designer clothing and accessories at a Saks Fifth Avenue department store. She was convicted of grand theft, shoplifting, and vandalism, but was acquitted on the felony charge of burglary. A year later, she was sentenced to 3 years of probation, 480 hours of community service, $3,700 in fines, and $6,355 in restitution to the Saks Fifth Avenue store. Ryder explained to Interview that the incident occurred during a difficult time in her life when she was clinically depressed. She also said that the medication she was on clouded her judgment, and the doctor that prescribed it subsequently had his medical license revoked. Sir Paul McCartney was arrested in Tokyo in 1980 for marijuana possession. Tokyo police found 8 ounces in his luggage. He told James Corden, "I still am hazy as to how that happened, but it did. I had some marijuana in my suitcase and I ended up in jail for 9 days. Scary. He said that he was only released early because of his celebrity status, and the actual sentence for his crime in Japan was 7 years of hard labor. After being released from jail, he was deported back to England. McCartney was forced to cancel the 11 shows he had booked with his band Wings, and he had to pay a compensation of $1.3 million. In May 2001, John Mayer was arrested for driving with a suspended license in Atlanta. The case against him was dismissed a month later, around the time that his debut album, Room for Squares, was blowing up. In 2009, Mayer offered $25,000 to charity if TMZ could turn up his mugshot. Didn't take long for that to happen, so Mayer wrote two checks each for $12,500 and donated them to Pet Orphans of Southern California and to Ace of Hearts. They're both organizations that rescue animals from the Los Angeles area and place them in adoptive homes. In 2004, TV icon and cookbook legend Martha Stewart was charged with securities fraud, obstruction of justice, and conspiracy. She wasn't actually convicted for the financial crimes, but was charged with conspiracy, obstruction of justice, and for lying to investigators. Stewart spent 5 months incarcerated in Alderson Federal Prison Camp in West Virginia. She was released in March 2005 and spent a further 5 months under house arrest at her home in Bedford, New York. Today, she refers to her stint in jail as nothing more than her horrible legal problem. And there you have it, 10 celebs who are a little more naughty than nice. Any celebs that you think should have made the list, let us know in the comments section below. And as always, like, share, and subscribe. And be sure to check back here to find out what else needs to be ranked.